Is it a fair argument that Judy Greer, in fact, is the inventor of G-Funk?
G-Funk.
Is it true? But you know what? A big confession from Judy before we get to her big directorial thing. Is it okay? I don't want to.
You're going to out me, but yes, it's right? Okay. You can
all right.
Do it.
Among Judy's many great efforts, and there's this great show on True TV that Andrea Savage does. She's been here to talk about it. It's called I'm Sorry. It's very funny. And you're one of her friends.
Funny, yes.
But you only know it's funny because it was funny while you made it.
And when I read the scripts.
That was funny.
Yeah.
But have you ever seen it?
I have not seen it yet. I hope she's sleeping and not. Andrea, I love you. I'm so sorry.
But here's the thing. But you get dispensation.
Thank you.
Because you're in everything.
Oh, yeah. I'd have to watch everything.
You'd be watching TV and movies all the time. Yeah.
But do you feel that way? I mean, you
No. No, because I watch things and I'm like, how did I not go up for that role?
Really?
Yeah, but probably because it was shooting when I was shooting something else, maybe. Mm. I don't know.
All right, here is the big, Fouaz, the person who's putting the show together today.
Yes?
She's like, she's coming on, I love her. Ask her, A, is she really good friends with Jennifer Garner? Because she gave that speech at like the Walk of Fame ceremony.
Gosh.
And are they going to do 13 Going on 30 again? And like, and she's in your new movie.
I am really good friends. That would be the greatest performance of my life if I wasn't really friends with Jennifer Garner
right.
made that speech. And I don't know about, we don't have any plans on redoing 13 Going on 30. Would we have to be like their moms or something?
Fouaz says it's a great idea.
Oh, really?
She's up for it.
I heard they're doing a musical of it.
Oh,
no
yeah,
one
right.
spoke to me.
Right.
Doesn't that feel weird, though, that no one spoke to you and there could be a musical on Broadway?
With like a role I originated.
Yeah. Right.
Maybe you'll get tickets.
I would love at least one. Like, maybe I get invited to the premiere.
Yeah.
Or the opening,
after party.
They call it. Yeah, the after party.
All right, so being in front of the camera for so many memorable and great things, you know, everybody says this, oh, I've got to direct.
Yeah.
Have you always felt that?
No, but I thought it would be really fun, and it was definitely in the back of my mind. But my manager, David Gardner, he's always pushing me to try harder and do more and expand my horizons.
Our representation won't return our calls.
You should call David Gardner. He's really good at it.
All right.
We started reading scripts like 5 years ago or something, and just needed to find the right project because it would take a year of my life, and you know I have a day job. So
right.
I wouldn't be able to act while I was doing it. And so finally this script came up and it was a movie that I thought was so funny. It was so heartfelt and a little dark, like a dark enough comedically for me to care about it. And I didn't have to be in it. I did not want to direct myself.
Right. Which you see some people doing that where they like run, you know, action.
Yeah.
And, they run
and hats off. But I don't think I would be able to sit in the editing room for 3 months and stare at my face.
Yes. All right. Common, Bradley Whitford,
yeah.
Katie Holmes,
yeah.
Allison Janney, who's in the clip.
Wow.
We're going to see Kamal Najani. Are these all your pals?
Yeah.
Did you literally call friends on your like?
I emailed. No one picks up if you call them. Mm. So yeah, I sent emails.
All right. Here's so a little bit. I think a murder mystery of sorts. Take a look. Watch this.
This guy's dead.
Yeah.
Well, this is how I found him. He was lying dead like this outside by a pile of manure.
Big pile of manure.
He was outside?
Yes.
And how did he get inside?
We moved him.
You moved him?
You bet we did. I mean, we had to wheelbarrow him up those stairs. It was a workout.
Do you know that moving a dead person without the consent of the family or civic authority is illegal?
Totally.
Whoop, whoop.
She gave the orders on that one.
Well, what were we supposed to do? You can't leave a corpse in the middle of a field. This school isn't public.
Next time you move a dead body, just make sure you ask permission first.
Very good. And then you go. And then you do go. Cut. Thank you, Katie Holmes.
Yeah. No. I mean, that was it was so surreal to see all my friends like listening to me when I when I was talking to them. But I didn't have to do a ton of direction. I mean, with those actors, you don't have
to.
But
like
much,
somebody like Allison Janney, who's so good in everything.
Yes.
Is it like Al? Here's an idea.
Oh, no. I just said, just never cut the camera. Mm. And like with her and Rob. And Rob was funny because I didn't know him. He wasn't a friend. But then I was flying home from a job in Vancouver and he was sitting next to me on the airplane.
Oh.
So we sat next to each other on the plane and we hit it off and had so much fun. And then when it came time to cast the movie, I was like, Rob Riggle would be amazing. Like I talked to him for 2.5 hours one day.
Right.
He's so great. And watching the two of them together. Yeah. No, I just kept the camera rolling.
Okay. We're on till 11. Do you want to just sit here?
Yes.
And the thought might be.
You guys should.
Or she'd have the opposite thought.
Happening of Monumental Proportions opens in select theaters today. Judy Greer, nice to see you.
Thank you, Judy.
Thank you. Morning News jumps back here in a minute.